In the previous class, already we discussed about the translation of access, the need to translate the access, and if you shift the origin in translation of access, how the coordinates of a point are changing, how the equations are changing, everything we discussed in the previous class, and I have two problems now. Just look at the board, bit B. By translating the access, so we are just translating the access. Translating the access in the sense, it is simply shifting the origin without changing the direction of axis. So, by this term, we need to understand that origin is shifted to some other point. You may say it has some h comma k. Usual notation. We shifted origin to a point h comma k.
Right.
Now the question is given that the equation xy minus 2x minus 3y minus 4 is equals to 0. Has changed to xy is equals to k. So already we used the new origin as h comma k. So just for our convenience, you just rewrite that k as t. Okay, and I need to find t. Just for our convenience. Now look at the problem. This is the old equation. As they mentioned, this is the new equation. By translating the axis. So we shifted origin to some point h comma k. In that process, by shifting that, old equation, original equation will become like this new equation. So we need to find the value of t. First of all, you just have a look. Since origin is shifted to h comma k, then we have a relation between the old coordinates and the new coordinates. What is that relation? What is that relation actually? Old coordinates small x is equals to capital X plus h, and small y is equals to capital Y plus k, as we discussed in the last class. So since this is the old equation, to convert it into the new equation, what we need to do? We need to replace small x with the capital X plus h, small y with the capital Y plus k. So I need to replace in such a way. So how it becomes? Yeah, the given equation xy minus 2x minus 3y minus 4 is equals to 0. You just replace x with capital X plus h. Capital X plus h into capital Y plus k minus 2 into capital X plus h minus 3 into capital Y plus k minus 4 is equals to 0. This is the old equation, and I am trying to find the new equation. The new equation is in terms of capital X and capital Y. So now you just multiply x plus h into y plus k. Okay? Yeah. So x into y, xy, x into k plus xk, and then h into y plus hy plus hk. Okay? And then minus 2x minus 2h minus 3y minus 3k minus 4 is equals to 0. You just observe here. Okay? Capital xy is a term, and then think about x terms, xk. So x is not there, x is not there, minus 2x, so no x is there. So what I need to write it like this, I can write it like a k minus 2 into x. Is there anything wrong? Just have a look. K minus 2 into x. Only these two terms have x. Okay. And then think about y terms. Okay. This is y term plus hy. And then search for y term. This is minus 3y. So these two are y terms. I can write it like this. H minus 3 into y. So xy term, x term, y term, and then all the remaining are just constants. What are those constants? Plus of hk minus 2h minus 3k minus 4 is equals to 0. So this hk minus 2h minus 3k minus 4 is the constant. Now, just for the space, I am erasing this actually. Okay, I think you all know this idea, right? Or otherwise, you just look there. I need new equation. Equation in the new system is of the format x into y is equals to t, xy is equals to t. Okay, That means I need only capital X, capital Y along with some T means a constant. I need capital XY term and constant term only. So this is capital XY term and this is constant term. So I don't need this X term and Y term. To eliminate this X term and Y term, you need to consider that what? K is equals to 2 and H is equals to 3. If you take K is equals to 2, this will get cancelled, 0. If you take H is equals to 3, that will get cancelled, this is also 0. So take K is equals to 2 and H is equals to 3. So if you, that's actually we need to find out, okay? If you observe that K and H are 2 comma 3, to eliminate this X and Y term, then there is the problem. If you replace K with 2, H with 3, what will happen? Okay, for that just I am using this space actually. You just look there. Now this is capital XY plus, so this is, since we are replacing K with 2, this is 0. So this term is not involved. Since we are replacing H with 3, this is 0. That is also gets eliminated. Then you left with this part into HK. HK means 2 into 3, 6 minus 2H, 2 into 3, minus 6 minus 3K, 3 into 2, minus 6 minus 4 is equals to 0. So 6 and 6 will get cancelled. 6 minus 4 is 2. So XY is equals to minus 2. So this is the new equation. So xy is equals to minus 2 and the value of t is equals to minus 2. That's our answer. Once actually observe it, translating the axis is mentioned. Since translating the axis is mentioned, that in turn represents that origin is shifted to some point. We don't know the new origin. Old origin is 0, 0, we know it. But we don't know the new origin. We don't know the coordinates of new origin. If you find out the coordinates of the new origin, then our task is simply easy, okay? So to find out the coordinates of new origin, this is the condition. The new equation is of the format xy is equals to some constant. That means x term and y term are not involved. So to eliminate that x term and y term, you just take k is equals to 2 as well take h is equals to 3. So from there, this is the format and your answer is minus 2. Okay, just have a look. So just observe the final calculation. Actually, I just cancelled out this minus 6 and minus 6. This is actually a wrong idea, right? We need to cancel out plus 6 and minus 6. So minus 6 minus 4 is minus 10. When you send it that side, you will get that xy is equals to 10 and your answer is 10. Okay? Right. Okay? Now, next 5A, similar type of problem, okay? Now, origin is shifted to 1 comma 2. As they mentioned, origin is shifted to 1 comma 2. Okay. And the equation y square minus 8x minus 4y plus 12 is equals to 0 is the what old equation. And has changes to y square plus 4ax is equals to 0. As they mentioned, changes to y square plus 4ax is equals to 0. We need to understand that this is capital Y square plus 4a into capital X is equals to 0. Our target is to find a. Now, since the origin is shifted to 1 comma 2, we know that old coordinate small x small y is equals to capital X plus new origin capital Y plus y coordinate of new origin. So you just simply replace X and Y in the old equation. Okay. Now, how, see, that is given equation is y square minus 8x minus 4y plus 12 is equals to 0. When compared with b bit, this is bit easy actually. Why? Because the new origin is already given, right? And now this y square, so y plus 2 whole square minus 8 into x is simply x plus 1 minus 4 into y plus 2 plus 12 is equals to 0. Just try to solve. Y square plus 4y plus 4, a plus b whole square, and then minus 8x minus 8, and then माइनस फोर वाई माइनस एट प्लस ट्वेल्व इज इक्वल टू जीरो. सो एट द एंड व्हेन यू ऑब्जर्व व्हाट विल हैपन, दिस फोर वाई एंड फोर वाई गेट्स कैंसिल एंड देन फोर प्लस ट्वेल्व सिक्सटीन एंड देन माइनस सिक्सटीन गेट्स कैंसिल. सो फाइनली वी लेफ्ट विद द फॉर्मेट y square minus 8x is equals to 0. So here the coefficient of x is 4a, here the coefficient of x is minus 8, therefore 4a is equals to minus 8 and a is equals to minus 2. That's the problem. Okay, just have a look. By shifting the origin, the locus equations of old system also will change. Okay, so according to the new equation, we need to find out that missing variable, missing value. Okay, chalo h value k value find out just an reason. చూడండి ఒకసారి ఈ ప్రాబ్లం ఏదైనా డౌట్ ఉంటే అడగండి. ఓకే
హలో సార్.
చెప్పరా
సార్. 1 కామా మైనస్ 2 సార్.
1 కామా
మైనస్ 2.
ఓకే కరెక్టేనా?
ఎస్ సార్.
ఓకే ఓకే మీతో ఆల్ గుడ్ చేయండి
సార్. 1 కామా మైనస్ 2 సార్.
రైట్ రైట్ వెరీ గుడ్. ఓకే ఓకే చాలా ఇక చాలు ఇక మ్యూట్లో ఉండండి. సో ఇంకొకసారి ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ చేసి అవి కంటిన్యూ. ఓకే so once again just look at the problem. After solving these two you will get that h is equals to 1 and k is equals to minus 2. Therefore we need to shift the origin to the point 1 comma minus 2 so that to eliminate that x term and y term. Okay, so once again look at the problem. Actually what is the given problem and what we are doing? Okay, old equation is given and we need to convert it into the new equation by shifting the origin so that it won't contain first degree terms x term and y term. So let the new origin as h comma k. So x is equals to x plus h and y is equal to y plus k. You just replace small x and small y with this capital x and capital y relations. You will get this as the new equation. And in this new equation, since we are trying to eliminate x term and y term, identify the coefficient of x and coefficient of y. So if you equalize it 0, you will get h comma k. So here you found it as 1 comma minus 2. So by shifting the origin to the point 1 comma minus 2, we don't have that x term and y term in the new equation. This is the actual process. But I have a generalization trick also for this. Okay, without doing this complete process every time. Okay, so we have a chance to generalize it. I am erasing and then I will give you. Okay, yeah. The same problem if you imagine. The same similar type of problem. Okay, just have a look on the board. I am mentioning it as like B. Okay, the point to which origin is shifted, the point to which origin is shifted to eliminate x comma y terms in a x square plus 2 h x y plus b y square plus 2 g x plus 2 f y plus c is equals to 0 is what? This is what actually we need to find. Okay, don't just confused about this H and that R is an H, okay? Otherwise, you just take here capital H. Okay. Just as we discussed in the previous case, just as we solved this problem, you just go with this equation now. This equation is completely involved with the coefficients A, H, B, G, F, C like that. When you solve in the same manner as we discussed in the previous case, you will get that new origin to eliminate x and y terms is simply nothing but this is the formula HF minus BZ divided by AB minus H square comma GH minus AF divided by AB minus H square. Just observe it. Just observe it, okay? So as we discussed in the previous case, again you just replace small x and small y with the capital X plus H and capital Y plus K. You will get a lengthy new equation corresponding to this. In that new equation, again, to eliminate X and Y terms, identify the coefficient of X, identify coefficient of Y, just equalize it to 0. And then try to find out the values of the new origin, H, K. You will get it as your answer, okay? So here we need to use, capital H. This H is a bit different from that H, okay? So this is the new origin. If you memorize this particular formula, HF minus BG by AB minus H square comma, GH minus AF by AB minus H square. So, is the new origin so that to eliminate X term and Y term from the given equation. If you memorize it, it is somewhat comfortable to find that new origin. Okay. Now, just look at the problem, first problem. Again, I will do for you using this particular formula. So, when you compare this given equation with this ax square plus 2hxy plus by square plus 2gx plus 2fx plus c is equals to 0, x square coefficient is 2. Here x square coefficient, here x square coefficient is 2. And then 2h is equals to 5. Here 2h is here 5. And then b is equals to 3. By square and 3y square. Next 2gx and it is 6x. So take that 2z is equals to 6. Next 2f. This is 2fy, this is 7y. 2f is equals to 7. The constant is 1. So c is equals to 1. So from there, what is the new origin? You just replace hf minus bz. What is h? H is actually 5 by 2 into f. What is f? 7 by 2 minus bg. B is 3 into z is also 3 divided by ab. A into b is 6. Minus h square, okay? These h's are capital H, okay? H square means this 5 by 2 whole square. Comma, gh, g is 3, h is 5 by 2, minus a is 2, f is 7 by 2, ab, product of these two, 6, minus h square, here h is 5 by 2, so 5 by 2 square. Use it like a formula. So just compare the given equation with the standard form. Identify all these values. Substitute in the formula. You will get the answer. Just you try to simplify it. You will get answer for sure. Okay. 5 sevens is what? 35. 3 threes is 9. 9 fours is 36. Okay. So 35 minus 36 is how much? Minus 1. Okay. Here again 24 minus 25. Okay, minus 1 by minus 1. On simplification, you will get it as minus 1 by minus 1 comma. Here again, just check it. Okay, 3 5s is what? 15. 2 7s is 14. 15 minus 14 by 2. That means 1 by 2 is the numerator. Whereas coming to the denominator, 24 minus 25 minus 1 by 4. So this is 1 by 2 divided by minus 1 by 4. When you solve, you will get 1 comma minus 2 as your answer. Just have it. So actually, I explained you the actual process. But without doing the complete process, we have another formula to find out the new answer. This is the formula. And to use this formula, we need to compare the given equation with the standard form. Identify the coefficient values. Substitute in the formula, on simplification you will get that new origin as 1 comma minus 2. Okay, so then this is one model, required and important model related to the translation of axis. there runs translation of axis, and in the next class I will start rotation of axis. Have a look.